Welcome everybody again. My name is Bart Krijsman. I work here since almost 2 years. Straight from university I came here. I work here as a project manager in the product realization team. And what that basically comes down to developing electronics in plastics. I want to continue on Artie's story about sustainability. Like, I'm going to put it even more in a nutshell. What we do is putting electronics in plastic shells. And there is something really bad about plastics, and that is that plastics are made of oil. Oil is a non-renewable resource, so all the oil we are using, I don't think I have to explain everybody anymore, brings in extra CO2 in our atmosphere, which results in the greenhouse effect. So the temperature on Earth is increasing. And I also don't think I have to explain you all the effects of that. I just show you one thing I stumbled upon last week. What you see here is a wildfire in California. Wildfires are not that rare in California. They happen every year in the wildfire season. Only they increase a lot. So since the 70s, the amount of wildfires and the sizes of the wildfires have been doubled. So that's huge. So the first time the temperature got measured in California in 1895 until now, the temperature has been increased with 2.3 degrees. You can already see now that the amount of wildfires has been doubled. So imagine what will happen if the temperature will rise even more. I show you here, this was the biggest wildfire of this year. It's the August complex. The August complex is 1 million acres big. I know there are many Dutch people here, so we do not know what acres are. So for your comparison, it's the same size as the province of North Holland. Dutch people think that's really big. And this was just only one fire, the biggest one. So this year, a total surface of 4 times North Holland has been burned down. So I think everybody's now refreshed with the fact of the urgency of the environmental problem, even though we don't see it every day. So instead of using oil, we can also use renewable resources. So I brought them here. This is corn and sugarcane. Those two, these products have in common that they contain a lot of starch. So the starch-rich crops, they can be turned to an industrial process of fermentation and later polymerization into PLA. And PLA is a really nice plastic. PLA is the name of the plastic, polyactic. And it's really nice because it looks like plastic, it feels like plastic. It can have the same applications as plastic, but it's also bio-based and biodegradable. Those are two things which are mixed up quite often. It's bio-based means that it's made from renewable resources, so it's made from the corn instead of oil. And biodegradable means that it can break down naturally by hand of microorganisms into natural compounds. Well, PLA has some side notes. It can only break down when you have an industrial plant which has exactly the right temperature and the right immunity and the right amount of microorganisms. But yeah, you do have, maybe people from the Netherlands know it, the plastic bags which can degrade, but those are really thin. But still, it can break down, so that's really nice.